I read the Quran, I read the Bible. I remember reading these books cover to cover. And then one day I just thought, you know what? I need to know. I need to know if Jesus is real.
Raisa was born in a religious Shia Muslim family in South London and grew up learning the Islamic faith.
I remember my mum and dad would have a mullah come into our house and teach us how to read the Quran. I definitely believed in Allah, so I never questioned that, but I never really felt any connection with God.
Raisa's family were quite conservative. They wanted her to follow the Islamic faith, but also keep her away from Western culture.
Had a very strict upbringing in the Shia faith. Other than going to school, I didn't really know anyone other than family.
In order to obey her parents, Raisa wanted to do everything they asked. However, there was something that she and her younger sister really enjoyed doing.
We love tennis, and I wanted to enter competitions, and they wouldn't allow that because it was not respectable for a Muslim girl.
Raisa's sport was becoming a threat to her parents, so they thought of doing something that Raisa had no idea of.
They explained to us that we were getting too Western, and they wanted us to experience their culture. And then after that, we went to Pakistan, and we were sat down one day, and my parents said, we have decided that you're not going back to England, but you're going to stay in Pakistan, and we're going to find you suitable husbands. I never ever thought something like that would happen to me, and it actually made me feel completely alone. I felt like, oh my goodness.
They stayed there for several months while Raisa's parents were hunting for their husbands. And then one night, when her parents were asleep.
We can't just sit here and wait for our parents to marry us off.
Raisa and her sister asked the security guards to help them run away, but they didn't know what was coming up next.
Well, basically, we trusted these guys to help us to escape. And they took us and they said, oh, well, the taxi's going to come a bit later. So in the meantime, they were trying to get a bit friendly with us, and we were not having any of that. So in the end, what happened was that they took us back home and literally threw us back into the front of the house.
She had to pay for the mistake she had made. Her parents forced her to marry a man from India and flew back to England after the wedding, not knowing that they had made the biggest mistake of their lives.
I was suddenly married to someone that I didn't really know. It just turned out that he didn't want to be married to me, and he actually wanted to come to England and have a job. His plan was for me to go back to England and sort out all his paperwork.
She flew back to England broken and hurt. There were many questions on her mind. Raisa even questioned her belief in Allah. She didn't do the paperwork for her husband or return to India. She joined the police force in London and moved out of her parents' house.
Through my work, I was introduced to this lady called Anna, and she was working with vulnerable young Asian women, and we just connected. We had the same heart and the same vision to, you know, to really try and reach out to them.
Anna was a believer, so she tried to share her faith with Raisa.
She was a very selfless person, and although I was not a bad person myself, I could see that there was something missing in my life that she had.
Raisa was trying to recover from what she had gone through. She didn't have the courage to believe again in anyone.
Just because I was so curious, I just said, look, why? What's so special about Jesus? I said, just tell me, why do you love Jesus so much? I just thought it's the most crazy thing. She told me who God was. That was so different to what I'd been taught. I was taught that Jesus was a prophet and he was like Muhammad. But hearing Anna's explanation of how actually Jesus was God in human form, coming and then giving his life and dying so that we could have a relationship with God, you know, and I thought, well, what if this is true? What if Jesus really is God and I'm believing in Muhammad and Allah and, you know, but what if this is not the truth? So for me then, from that point onwards, I was determined to find the truth about God. Who is God? And I just knelt down and I just prayed to God and I said, Jesus, if you are real, if you are who you say you are, then I hear your voice, that you're knocking on the door. I open my heart and I want you to come in. Suddenly, the minute I said that, it just felt like I was flooded with love. It was an instant feeling of being washed and accepted, and I knew then that this Jesus is real. Worry and fear and everything was just like washed away. This love that I just felt complete, I knew I had met God, I had met Jesus. The Bible is the final word. It is the word from God. You know, in the Quran, it does say that Jesus is the word of God.
Raisa gave her life to Jesus that day and never looked back. She is now married to a godly man named Richard, and they live in Hereford with their three beautiful children. Raisa runs a cookery class and testifies to the love of Jesus with others, especially women who have gone through similar situations in life. Her family never accepted her back after she became a Christian, but Raisa found a new family in Jesus, which is eternal.
God is always with me. He'll never leave me or forsake me. And I also believe that he will bring my family together and bring my family to him as well. I do believe that.